Hello, my name is Kenneth Gordon. I'm a dermatologist at Northwestern University, and I'll be discussing a recent New England Journal of Medicine article on the medication Ixekizumab for the treatment of psoriasis. This article is a compilation of three phase three trials looking at the short-term data from one trial and longer-term data from all three put together. It's important to put Ixekizumab in the context of all the new medications we've developed for psoriasis over the last 10 to 15 years. We've had numerous biologic medicines develop starting in 2003 that we've had access to. But what's really different and what's gone on over the last few years is the development of new levels of efficacy that we can use for treating our patients with psoriasis. The standard we've used for many, many years has been the PASI 75, or 75% improvement in the psoriasis area and severity index. When we first started with medications like Elefacept or Eflazimab, we had levels of response of about 25 to 30%. That was improved upon with the anti-TNF agents, etanercept of about 50%, and adalimumab of about 75%. And ustekinumab was in the same context as adalimumab, about 70 to 75% PASI 75. But with the advent of the newer medications treating blocking interleukin 17, like secukinumab, but in this case, ixekizumab, what we found is higher levels of response. And numerous areas of information have suggested that getting higher levels of response, at least a PASI 90 or a 90% improvement in this in the PASI, or even a PASI 100 in complete clearance, really makes a difference to our patients. We were really never measuring those numbers before because the numbers of subjects in clinical trials that reached those levels was relatively low. However, with studies like those that were published in this article, really suggest that those levels are attainable. So let's go through the article for a moment. The important thing is looking at the short-term and long-term data associated with ixekizumab. We have one of the short-term trials, 12 weeks, of ixekizumab versus placebo in this trial, and it showed a PASI 75 rate in the high 80s and approaching 90%. PASI 90, about 70%, and PASI 100, complete clearance, approaching 35 to 40%. And that was consistent with the data that was seen in other short-term trials of ixekizumab. But even more important was looking at the longer-term data, where the PASI 75, PASI 90, and even complete clearance was maintained very nicely over 60 weeks of therapy. This is the kind of response that we haven't seen before in psoriasis therapy and really adds to our ability to take care of patients. I think there's one other piece of important information in the efficacy portion of this paper that's hidden in the supplemental materials of the paper, and that is looking at the production of anti-drug antibodies and their impact on disease and therapy. So one of the things that we've always wondered is, what is the true impact of development of anti-drug antibodies? And how does that really impact therapy? Because the only thing that's really important is whether the patient is getting better or not. And what we can see in this trial is that while a number of patients had anti-drug antibodies against ixekizumab, relatively few actually had a clinical impact. So it was clear that the titers of the anti-drug antibodies were very significant. But only about 1.7% of patients had any impact on their outcomes. What that tells us is that in a drug that acts so highly on patients in terms of making them better, the presence of anti-drug antibodies really only detracts a very, very small proportion of the response. Obviously, when looking at long-term therapy for psoriasis, safety is of great significance as well. And the power of having a paper that has all three major clinical trials in the phase three program together gives a great deal of power when looking at safety, with over 1,200 subjects being studied. What we find in this trial is that even though there is a slight increase in the number of candidal infections that one can see, and that would be predictable by the nature of the drug, these were very mild, and no patients had to stop the therapy based on candidal infections. other things that we're concerned about, things like major adverse cardiac events, serious infections, were very, very low rates and comparable to what was seen in placebo and even with the comparator of etanercept. So in looking at this paper in a larger sense, what we see is very high levels of response along with a good safety record, and something that we strongly believe that ixekizumab, based on these data, should be a major player in the treatment of psoriasis over the next few years.